have no story. Did I be hearing it?
Well, I don't know about you, but I'm pretty darn pleased with how that went.
Absolutely.
Here, here.
Bloody good show.
Yay!
Yes, well, I didn't care for it.
There's a surprise.
What do you mean by that?
Nothing.
Where's Anne? I've just realised she's missing.
She just messaged me. Oh, apparently she's stuck at the vet's with her cat. Apparently Mr. Mittens was chasing a bird and got stuck in a bird feeder. He's got to have his paw bandaged. Poor thing.
Have you been chasing birds too, Maggie?
You're supposed to break a leg, Maggie, not an arm.
It's just a nasty sprain, apparently. All that bouncing and swaying gave me a spinny head. Before I knew it, I was on the floor. So Anne isn't going to make it then, Janet?
No, she has apologised, but she says she's up for doing anything next time, as long as she has a first name.
Gerald's missing as well.
It's not like him to be late.
How would you know? You're never on time.
I'm here now, aren't I?
Doesn't seem quite right, celebrating without him.
Exactly.
Never mind. He obviously feels he's got more important things to do. So, I suggest we press on and discuss our next production.
Oh, no.
We've only just finished this one.
Yes, and the sooner we put it behind us, the better.
What do you mean? I loved it.
Me too.
Me three.
Cynthia, can we not just stop and enjoy the moment?
No. So, what I have planned is another groundbreaking masterpiece. My own original works, of course. This time, the story will follow.
Whoa!
Blimey!
Good grief, Gerald. Are you all right? Sorry I'm late.
Never mind that. Are you okay, Gerald?
I'm fine. At least, so the doctors at the hospital tell me. I'm not convinced.
The hospital?
What happened, Gerald?
I was poisoned.
What?
Poisoned.
Jesus!
What?
Got home this afternoon after a brisk stroll around the lake to a basket on my doorstep. Inside was a freshly made batch of courgette surprise. Well, I assumed it was a thank you from one of you for all my efforts in directing the murder mystery. Apparently, I was wrong.
Oh, my God, Gerald.
I can't believe it.
Was there a note?
No.
No note? And you still ate this mystery meal having no idea where it came from?
Well, it hardly crossed my mind that someone was trying to poison me.
This is awful.
Who would do something like that?
Maggie?
Don't you look at me. I didn't do it. I'm just an innocent bystander.
This isn't murder on the online express now, Maggie. You're not Daisy, the waitress who knows no one and nothing. In fact, you're the only one who knows the recipe.
That's not true. Remember? I gave it to Babs several times because she keeps losing it.
Well, I didn't do it. And I pinned the recipe to the village hall notice board last week, so it could have been anyone.
You did what? That's my secret family recipe.
Not anymore.
Well, I didn't think you'd mind. It's been a good year for the courgettes. I just thought it'd be nice to share with the community.
Oh, yes, very nice. Just look at Gerald here. I'm sure he's very grateful.
Well, how was I to know this was going to happen?
You weren't Babs. Come on now, Maggie. Why would Babs want to poison Gerald?
Exactly. Thank you, Harriet.
That's a good point. Babs doesn't have much of a motive.
Oh, here we go.
But Alistair here, well, he's got an axe to grind, hasn't he? I mean, after all, Gerald cast me as a leading man instead of him. I mean, that must have smarted.
Or in fact, maybe George did it in some pathetic attempt to extend his role as Detective Dick before being cast back to the shadows again. Oh, now don't worry, George. You might not be a detective anymore, but you'll always be a Dick.
Nice try, pal. But I don't cook. Cheryl does it all for me.
Lucky lady.
Look, let's just move on, shall we? After all, he's fine, isn't he? No harm done. There's no need to point the finger of blame at each other.
Cynthia, are you serious? Someone has tried to poison Gerald. He needs to call the police.
I quite agree.
Can you call them now, Gerald?
It's difficult to speak.
You poor thing.
Do you want one of us to come and sit with you, Gerald?
Oh, no. You know me. I don't want to make a fuss.
Of course not.
I'm lucky to be alive.
I just don't understand who would do this. And to ruin a perfectly good courgette surprise.
That's hardly the point, is it, Maggie?
Of course not. I was just saying.
Where do you even get poison from?
Oh, it's easier than you'd think. There's a black market for these things on the internet.
You seem to know a lot about it.
I don't live under a rock, George.
I just can't believe it. Poison. I mean, poison.
And who's next?
Definitely you.
Poison?
Oh, for Christ's sakes, it wasn't poison. It was just chili powder.
What?
Cynthia?
What the hell?
What? Come on. I just wanted to get my own back after he made me a dead body for the last 3 weeks. It was just a joke.
Ha! Ha!
Well, it wasn't very funny, Cynthia.
Oh, come on. Look, he's fine.
He went to the hospital.
Yes, but for chili powder. Seriously, that's a complete overreaction.
Actually, it's a complete allergic reaction.
What?
I'm allergic to chili.
You're allergic?
To chili, yes. Sets off my asthma. I'll be wheezing for days.
Oh, nice one, Cynthia.
Good job.
Really, Cynthia?
How could you?
I can't believe you do that, Cynthia. So thoughtless of you.
All right, enough. Look, Gerald, I'm sorry. Honestly, it was just meant to be a joke. I never meant to harm you. Please say you'll forgive me, Gerald. After all, we've been friends for such a long time.
Have we?
Some friend.
There must be something I can do, Gerald. Some way I can make things right.
I don't know, Cynthia. You've really crossed a line.
I know. And for that, I am truly sorry, Gerald. But we have to move past this, don't we? For the sake of the company, if nothing else.
Well, there is one thing.
Anything, Gerald. Anything at all. Just name it.
I already have, actually. Death on Piste.
What?
My new murder mystery.
Death on...
Piste. Because this time, it'll be set in a ski resort. Very seasonal, don't you think? A group of unfortunate holidaymakers will get more than they bargained for, with slalom ski moves, swinging cable cars, and snowstorms. And murder! On the slopes.
Wow,
really exciting.
Another murder mystery?
Something the matter, Cynthia?
When do we start?